In this video, we will discuss about two-way ANOVA. Two-way ANOVA is an extension of one-way ANOVA. In two-way ANOVA, we will be having more than two independent variables and one dependent variable. Let us see this with the help of an example. If you see the example on the screen, I have two independent variables. The first one is income, the second one is family members. Income and family members are ordinal data. Income has three levels and family members also having three levels. And dependent variable is expenditure. It is amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo. Using two-way ANOVA, I want to find, is there any significant difference between the monthly income to the amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo purchase? One more hypothesis I have, null hypothesis. Is there any significant difference between number of family members in the house to the amount of expenditure on shampoo? Before we start the analysis, we must first frame the null hypothesis, as first hypothesis is amount of monthly expenditure for different income do not differ. The second null hypothesis is amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo for different number of family members in house do not differ. And there is a third null hypothesis, which is based on the interaction of income and family members. The null hypothesis is amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo do not differ for the interaction of income and number of family members. Now let us see the procedure of doing two-way ANOVA. Click Analyze. In this, select General Linear Model and select Univariate. Select amount of monthly expenditure as dependent variable, monthly income as fixed factor. The second fixed factor is number of family members. Click OK. Now I want to test of between subject effects. Now see the income. I have SIG value is 0.096. If the SIG value is less than 0.05, then we reject the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis is stated as amount of monthly expenditure for different income do not differ. As the SIG value is greater than 0.05, we retain the null hypothesis. It means different income people, there is no difference for the amount of expenditure they do. Second null hypothesis is family members, related to family members. The family members SIG value is 0.00, which is less than 0.05. So we reject the null hypothesis. It is the amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo for different number of family members in house, there is a difference. And the third null hypothesis is income interaction with family members. The SIG value is 0.733, which is greater than 0.05. We retain the null hypothesis. It means amount of monthly expenditure on shampoo do not differ for the interaction of income and number of family members. In this way, two-way ANOVA helps us for having the interaction between two independent variables and individually for each independent variables.